Hi everyone, INFJ are not the only one type who absorb people's emotions and energy. Everyone, every type can detect and feel people's energy and emotion, environmental energy, but I think certain types, or rather persons, are more sensitive to energies, detect them better, and are more impacted, shaken by them. Neurodivergent people are more sensitive to energies. They have a different and deeper relation with the world and living beings. Their bodies are more sensitive to stimulation than the average neurotypical person. They often feel more deeply than some neurotypical counterparts. Neurodivergent don't filter the world, they interpret reality with less biases. Both INFJ and INTJ absorb people's energies and environmental energy, and therefore emotion of others, because emotions are also energy, and more when they are neurodivergent and spiritually awakened. When we raise our consciousness, we raise our intuition and our sensitivity to energies, and their absorption is amplified. When we are more connected to ourselves, we are also more deeply connected to the energies, more in tune and aligned with the life, more conscious of the oneness. So I think our sensitivity to energies and their absorption depend of many things, of the introversion, of the intuition, of the neurodivergence, and of the level of spiritual awakening. To give you some examples, a spiritually awakened and neurodivergent INFJ or INTJ or any other intuitive type is more sensitive to energies and absorbs them more than a typical INFJ or INTJ or any other intuitive type or any other type. An ESTP or ESFP with ADHD is more sensitive to energies than a typical ESTP or ESFP. A neurodivergent and spiritually awakened ISTJ is more sensitive to energies than a typical ISTJ. Years ago, I knew a coworker ISTJ. She was very sensitive to the energies. And an ISTJ doctor, one day she told me she learned the intuition, this capacity. I noticed her energy was very different than before. She was more calm, more at peace, more compassionate, more open and receptive. All psychological types, everyone can detect and absorb energies, and the most sensitive one do it more. The difference between the 16 types is they process and manage the energies differently. The extrovert tend to move on quickly from an energy to the next, jumping from one to another, replacing one with another. The introvert seems hold on longer the energies, fully experience them, and only after move on. The sensor seems to have a filter, maybe they feel the energy more in surface. The intuitive seems to have no filter, they feel their soul is exposed, they experience the energy deeply and more intensely. I think the Enneatype has less influence or not at all because two INTJ Enneagram 8 friends are as sensitive to energies as I am. When a vehicle passes or makes noise, we feel like it passes through our body, as if we were one with the thing or the energy. At the same time, we are ourselves energy, and we process many different types of energies. Another interesting example, a friend who has the same personality as me, same personality type, same Enneatype, same tri-type, instinctual variant, same neurodivergence. I absorb energies, people don't notice me, I am almost invisible, no one notice me, and she absorbs nothing, she is immune. Everyone notices her presence. But people always feel seen and observed by us with our Enneatype. We are the same on certain points and the perfect opposite on certain other traits. Absorbing energies is more a neurodivergent thing, or at least with the neurodivergence it is intensified. If we imagine an energy absorption spectrum, typical persons are in the middle and the neurodivergent have more chance to be at the extreme, at the beginning, and at the end of the spectrum, by being not sensitive, or hypersensitive, or both. Yes, we can be both. We are really paradox. Sometimes we can be hypersensitive and sometimes we can be not sensitive at all. In the case when INFJ and INTJ absorb and are surely neurodivergent, NI experience the energies deeply, intensely, fully, but they don't let other energies controlling them. NI go their own way, they don't want to be influenced by other energies. They will try to avoid the bad and hurtful one and to be around the good and healing one. And even more for INTJ, because of our FE, a stricter function. We don't want to be influenced by other people, and it is really useful. The difference between INFJ and INTJ absorbing energies and emotions of others is that with FE, people's feelings and your own are mixed together. FE is be aligned with the feeling of others, aligned with emotional atmosphere of the group, having the same, they think it is their own, feel it as if it was their own, they may let them be influenced by other energies and feelings. They sense, feel other energies and feelings, absorb them, but they are confused if it is their own or not. With FI, we are aware, discern, distinguish that people's energies and feelings and ours are separated. We sense, feel them, absorb them, but we know it is not our energy, not our feeling. Only us decide if we want to be influenced by other energies and feelings. It is harder to influence us. It is something reserved to our close circle, to the people we value and feel close to them. In short, we decide to be influenced or not by other people's and energy. So don't try to control us. We decide. Also, with FI as third child function, we may have difficulty, struggle to manage our own feeling and energy, so we don't want to manage and be bothered by the one of others. It is already painful to have our own. We don't want to feel the pain of others in addition to ours, especially when we are hyper-empathic, it is painful. But when we are mature, we are compassionate and we like to help others. Also, I learned recently that the emotion can override the intuition, so it is better for the random to be emotionally stable that we take decisions based on our intuition and not with emotion. The other function, other than NI, they feel it, feel the energy, but then move on, they may let the other energy control them. With NI1, SE4, NI dominant function, SE inferior function, they have less capacity for SE information, they are more overwhelmed or overloaded by it, and NI taking, absorbing information more deeply and directly. NI doesn't filter the world, it sees the real reality, the essence, they seem to be more sensitive to the world, the information goes straight and deep in their mind, and this sensibility is amplified when they are neurodivergent and spiritually awakened. It is like their soul, essence, being is directly exposed to the world without filter, without shield. They have to build a psychic shield around them. With the time, we can find a way to better manage the absorption of energies and better manage this sensibility by building, creating a psychic, spiritual shield. Imagine a bubble around us. It can be whatever we want, made it with what we want. Just visualize ourselves and use imagination. For example, we can imagine a layer made of solid metal, another layer made of mirrors to reflect energies, another layer made of white light, and another layer of golden light, and many layers. Imagine whatever you want. By refocusing our consciousness on ourselves, imagine the biofield, imagine the energy circulate from the outside to the head, crown chakra, to the root chakra, to the outside, recycling energy more quickly, we can experience it, feel it. By avoiding certain places and people, energies, spending more time alone, in calm, at home, outside, at night, or in nature, with meditation, listen healing frequencies and brainwave to recharge and heal faster, the body and the mind, and also with mantra, Reiki symbol, Viking rune symbol, and crystal can heal and protect ourselves. So I think absorbing energies from people, things and environment is more a neurodivergent thing. A highly sensitive person is a neurodivergent individual who is thought to have an increased or deeper central nervous system, and that surely an item have more chance to be neurodivergent, more chance it concerns them. Thank you so much for watching and protect yourself. I know you need a lot of alone time. By building, creating a psychic, spiritual child, spiritual shield.